Yo, what's up guys, it's your boy Anizi here, back at it with part 3 of What If Naruto was Marjan Hashirama's reincarnation. So guys, last time Naruto made his own Zetsu called Woody, and after that he left the village for the mist. On the way there, he heard rumors of how the waterfall was treating the Jinchuriki, so he saved her before continuing to wave. He then saved Inari's father from Gato and then trained with Fu at the Wave Village. He did some missions for Wave, like eliminating bandits, restoring peace to Wave, and after that he went and saved Mai and her niece from being killed. He also killed the loyalists in the Mist War, becoming a hero of Wave, and he also earned SSS rank in the bingo book, with his partner Fu having S rank. Minato was in his office doing some paperwork. He was pissed he couldn't spend time with his precious Menma and Mito. Not only that, but his son had bad chakra control. Amito was arguing, thinking that she was the best because she was always ahead of Menma. Krishna suggested bringing back Naruto so that they can make Menma feel good, but Jiraiya refusing, the demon would corrupt them. He was confused that someone had killed the root that was stationed to stop the village from being attacked, but he thought nothing of it. He thought Danzo was just training his own root. He was also pressurized by the elders to get a contract with the Mist Village as they had recovered from the war. He was also fuming that someone had killed Gato, as he was secretly funding Gato so that he can make his children look good when they save Wave Village, and it also secured them an alliance with Wave. "Sensei, the bingo book has arrived," Kakashi said. "Why is it late?" Minato said. "I heard the Raikage was going to change some information of a shinobi in the book. He's taken an apprentice or something like that," Kakashi said. "Oh really?" Minato said as he started to read the bingo book or looking for threats. He then stumbled on the S rank ninja who went by the name of Bug Queen, a former rogue waterfall ninja now in the cloud. She was Fuda the Seven Tails Jinchuriki. "What?" Minato shouted. "How dare the Raikage takes another Jinchuriki? He's disturbing the flow of balance." Krishna then came in after hearing Minato scream. "Hi Minato-kun, is everything right?" she said. "Yeah, it is, Krishna. It's just that the Seven Tails are joined the cloud village," Minato said. "Stupid bitch, she should have come to us," Krishna said. "So, want to read a bigger book with me?" Minato said. "Menma and Mito were at school." "Sure," she said. When they turned the page, they were in shock and fear. Bingo book entry number 0308. Alias, the true god of shinobi. Name, Naruto Uchiha Uzumaki Senju. Bloodlines and ability, legendary Rinnegan, legendary world release, and internal Mangekyo Sharingan. Also the Nine Tails Jinchuriki. Village allied to Hidden Cloud. Feats, killed Gato, saved the land of Wave. Killed 100,000 shinobi off the mist and dropped a meteor on the rest. Killed Jiagara, the Mizukage, and secured the Mist and Wave Alliance for the Cloud Village. Known family, Minato Namikaze, Yellow Flash, disowned. Krishna Uzumaki, Red Death, disowned. Madara Uchiha, Ghost of Uchiha, deceased. Hashirama Senju, the God of Shinobi, deceased. Said to be greater than his father in his prime, and on par with Madara and Hashirama, his grandfathers, at their prime. He's called the Legacy of Madara and Hashirama, as it was confirmed by the Raikage through blood tests that he is their grandson. He is also a perfect Jinchuriki of the Nine Tails. Orders, do not engage. I repeat, do not engage. He is unstoppable. We had to make him his own rank. Anbu, bring the fake Naruto running around our village now, Minato shouted. We then see Woody being dragged into Minato's office. So, Naruto, do you know why you are here? Minato said. No, the so-called Naruto said, as Minato then jams a kunai into Naruto's chest as the illusion fades away, revealing a black gooey mess. How did you know? Woody asked. Bingo book, Minato said. Oh, so the boss has finally finished with his goals. He's either part of the cloud or mist by now, Woody said. You dare help the demon betray us? Now our home looks weak. We lost the strongest shinobi we could have had, according to the bingo book. This is going to damage our village's reputation. And now the cloud also has four Jinchuriki, which makes them the strongest, when these should be the strongest. Is it true about us being related to either Madara or Hashirama? Minato asked. Well, you're lucky the boss said I could tell you about that. And yes, you lot are related to Madara and Hashirama, so yeah. But unlike Naruto, you're not their reincarnations either, so yeah. But Naruto is the reincarnations. Minato-kun, that means that Menma and Mito will be amazing, Krishna said. No, they're not. They're not perfect hybrids. They won't unlock any bloodlines, unlike Naruto, who is perfectly one-third Senju, one-third Uchiha, and one-third Uzumaki. A perfect hybrid. While Menma and Mito are just Namikazes, because the three bloods in them were fighting for control, are utilizing the Kyuubi's chakra, and they destroyed themselves, leaving only the Namikaze genes, Woody said, laughing at Menma and Mito. And also Krishna and Minato. Minato and Krishna got angry at this. Well, whatever, you piece of shit, it's time for you to go to jail for helping a fugitive escape. And also for using a false identity and staying in our village, Minato said, as Woody laughed and all the Anbu came charging towards him. They all died as he let out an aura. That's my aura of despair, and I believe it's time that I left, Willy said as he went into the ground. He went to the secret base that Marden Hashirama left and sealed it into a scroll and left to find its master. Alright, so now we're going to graduation day. Naruto's life in Cloud was perfect. He now had a family and friends, which he never had back in the Leaf Village. His family consisted of Raikage, who is like a father, Bee, who is like a brother, and Yugato, who is like an older sister, and Fu, who is like a younger sister. His friends were Kari, Dari, and Samui. He was also friends with Kira Turumi, who came over to the Cloud to hang around from the Mist Village, since a Cloud and Mist had their alliance, and Wave also had an alliance with Mist and Cloud. Naruto over here was treated like royalty, bringing three legendary bloodlines that were feared throughout the elemental nations, and also Leaf's most powerful techniques, because when Naruto left, he also stole the Scroll of Sealing, and also brought another asset, the Ninetales. Naruto was feared throughout the nations, which also guaranteed Cloud's safety, as he was a perfect deterrent for war. He also graduated at the Rookie of Years. So now it's the team selection day. Before I announce the team, Team 1 and 2 will be a special elite team, led by one Jonin instructor. Team 1 consists of Naruto, Yugato, and Fu, and the second team under Killer Bee will be Samui, Dari, and Kaori. Killer Bee then came in and told the teams to meet them at the waterfall in the Cloud Village. All shinobi body flickered there, as they weren't Leaf trash and they knew that shit. Okay, so I am your sensei. Before we start off, we'll go with the introductions. I will go first and then you will go. Okay, so follow my example. My name is B and I'm the Eight-Tails. My likes are the village, my family, and rapping. I hate Leaf and I hate villagers who treat Jinchuriki as trash. My dream has already been fulfilled. So let's skip most introductions. My name is Naruto Uchiha Uzumaki Senju. I am the Ninetales Jinchuriki and the former son of the fourth Hokage. I like the Cloud Village and Jinchuriki. I despise the Leaf and I will destroy it one day. My dream is to restore my clans and show the world the true power of Uchiha Uzumaki and Senju, not the jokes that they have at Leaf. I mean, look at Tsunade, she doesn't have the wood release and she calls herself Senju. Uzumaki, well, my so-called brother and sister don't even have chakra chains. And Uchiha, that little Sasuke couldn't even unlock his Sharingan yet. Good, so now normally we will do a test, but since you already know teamwork, we will start by doing missions. Over the months, Team Elite, which was Team 1 and 2, had done several B and A rank missions. Naruto's team had gotten a summon. Naruto had gotten the dragon summoning from the land of Whirlpool. Mito had told him to go there to find it. Mito Uzumaki, not Mito Namikaze. By convincing Raikage that all Uzumaki artifacts belonged to him and therefore the Cloud. Fu had found a phoenix contract from a volcano that they went to in a mission to stop a group of A-rank ninjas from attacking a village. Yuta had gotten the white tiger contract from the Two-Tails, who is friends with the clan head. B had gotten a black tortoise summon by defeating its boss summon in a battle and proving himself worthy. We now see Naruto in the Raikage's office. Team Elite, you have been chosen to enter the Chunin exams by your sensei. If you have anything to say, say it now. Nobody said anything. Good, so the team will be split into three mans. Team 1 is our Jinchurikis and Team 2 is Samui, Dari and Omui. He said, yes sir, they all shouted. Before you go, all of the great five nations will be competing and Rock wants to join our alliance, so after the second stage, Team Jinchuriki will be accompanying me to the Rock Village so we can finalize the agreements. Now you have 2 weeks to train, he said. Yes sir, they said. We now see Naruto training at a mountainside. Above him, a purple portal opens up. Looking up, he sees a heavily injured pale girl falling from the sky. Naruto then flies up using his wind manipulation and catches her. He didn't notice, but the girl was blushing as she snuggled in closer to Naruto's chest. Naruto then landed. Hi, I'm Naruto Uchiha Uzumaki Senju. Who are you and what was that and why were you injured? He asked. Hi, I'm Miyako Osuki and I'm running from some Hyugas who tried to put a caged bird seal on me for refusing to join the clan and marry the Hokage's kid. I then used the portal to escape. Before I managed to escape, they managed to harm me by shooting jutsus and kunais at me, she said, a bit scared. So the stupid Leaf shinobis would force a woman to marry someone using seals, Naruto thought, enraged. Well, don't worry about them now. You're in the Cloud and this is our territory. They can't come here and you're protected from them now. Yaku then started to blush. Thanks, Naruto-kun, she said. So Yaku, who's your parents? Are you a Hyuga? I see that you have the Bakugan, Naruto said. No, I'm actually the sister of the Sage of Six Paths and the daughter of Kage Otsuki, the goddess of Chakra. I've been sealed in the moon until recently I just got out after I opened a portal and went to Earth where I landed in Leaf. And the Leaf power hungry shinobi saw me and took me to the Hokage where he tried to sell me to the Hyuga clan. And in return, I would marry Menma because he sensed my high chakra levels. When in Leaf, my life was hell. Menma and the Ninja Clan boys always tried forcing me to date them. And I refused, and then everybody started hating me. They started calling me a bitch and everything. I just wanted to find someone to love me, just like Mother told me that people would, but they just hurt me. Menma had always tried to force himself onto me, but I always managed to escape thanks to Anko. Don't worry, Yarko. Rest. I'll protect you from now. I'll protect you from this Leaf. I hate Leaf as well. I hate the Hyugas and Menma, not to say enraged. Yarko then stumbled over as her injuries had not healed yet, not to quote her bridal style, and took her to the village. So Yarko, if you have this power that Minato wants, how come you weren't able to defend yourself from the Leaf? Minato asked. Well, when I managed to escape from the moon, it used all my power. I couldn't even use my power. Minato just felt the little bit of power that I had, and once he saw that it went away, he knew that I was weak, so he tried to get his son to marry me. Well, he tried to force me to marry his son. Yarko then fell asleep in Minato's arms as he carried her to the house. The next morning, Yarko woke up. She then went downstairs to see Minato. So Yarko, I talked to the Raikage and got you into the village as a citizen. And don't worry, we don't really care if you have the Bakugan, because you're not going to be forced to breed or have any CRA or anything like that, because the Cloud Village isn't like that. And you have the option if you want to be a ninja or anything like that. You can stay as much as you want, and this place is secured, so Leaf trash can't get in here, Naruto said. Naruto, why do you hate the Leaf so much? I get why I hate them, but what's your reasoning? Yarko asked. Naruto then explained everything to Yarko, his childhood and the neglect and everything. And Yarko then comforted him. Oh yeah, by the way, I'll be going to the tuning exams, so you will have the house to yourself for the next month or two. Yeah, Naruto said. Oh, okay, please beat Menma and that Hinata for me. Menma tried to force me to be with him, and Hinata tried to cage birds with me so I can be Menma and her slave, Yarko said, crying. Naruto then hugged her and said, don't worry, Yarko, I'll avenge both of us. I'll avenge what Menma and Mita did to me, and I'll avenge what Menma and Hinata did to you. For the next week, Naruto stayed with Yarko, showing her around, taking her on dates, and also helping her get used to people. She also helped him by letting him have someone who could share his anger and hatred for Leaf, and also comforted him. In Naruto's mindscape, I told you I was right to destroy that place, Hashirama, Madara said. I do regret destroying and killing those people, Kurami said. I don't know. Everything I did, my legacy, is all ruined. It's all because of the damn Hyugas, that damn Minato, Hashirama shouted with a mixture of sadness and anger. To think they'll resort to forcing someone to get married just for bloodlines and just for power. My legacy has been ruined. Naruto is my only legacy now, Hashirama said as he roared out in rage. Back with Naruto. After hearing Hashirama's breakdown, he vowed to get revenge on Leaf for ruining his grandfather's legacy. Okay, so now we're at the day of the exams. We now see Naruto's team and Samui's team walking down to the Leaf. They are stopped by the gate. Stop, identify yourself and your purpose for being here. B then walked up to the guards and said, we are here for the tuning exam. Here's our paper saying that we are allowed. Their eyes widened when they saw Naruto's name as the Hokage informed them. You may enter. Here's your passes, the Chunin said, handing the passes. The Cloud team then proceeded while wearing masks so the Leaf wouldn't notice Naruto to go to the hotel. The Cloud team then proceeded to go to the Leaf Academy to their first test. When they got there, they took off their masks and went to the entrance and went into the waiting area. When Naruto was there, he saw the hate on Krishna's face as she looked at him, but there was also a bit of regret and fear. But then B comes and wishes his team luck as they proceeded to walk into the waiting area for the shinobis. When they get there, Menma and Mito instantly recognized him as they and the rookies come up to him. Demon, what are you doing here? Menma asked. Why are you here? You should have stayed dead, Mito said. First of all, Menma, I'm here for the same thing as you, to get a promotion and compete in the tuning exam to show my village's power. And secondly, Mito, who said I was dead? Oh, the stupid villagers, of course. Those idiots can't let go of grudges. Don't talk about the Leaf like that. And why did you join that stupid Cloud village that tried to kidnap our mum? Well, my mum, Menma said. They won't need that bitch of a mother. They have me, Naruto said. As Kabuto then comes over and stops the argument, Naruto then returns to his team. Menma Mito proceeds to ask Kabuto about them. Kabuto then reads out the bingo book entries and tells them that their team has done 0 D ranks, 0 C ranks, 69 B ranks and 25 A rank and 1 S rank. Shocking, Menma. How is the demon so strong? Menma asked.
There's no way he's stronger than my Memma or Sasuke. Hinata, you know, and Sakura said, that demon is dangerous, Mito said. He's not that strong. And Uchiha like me can beat that 25% Uchiha, Sasuke said. Oh really? Hinata then heard that and said, oh really, Sasuke? Your family was Fugaku. Well, guess what, Sasuke? My family was Madara Uchiha, the strongest of the Uchihas. While your father was nothing but a failure. I mean, under his rule, the clan was massacred by his own son, your brother. And Sasuke was pissed off at this. I can't wait to show the leaf its place as the weakest of the five great nations, Naruto said, laughing, pissing off all the leaf ninjas, even the Chunins and Jonins that were there. You dare mock us, demon, Memma said, as he started to channel the Kyuubi's chakra. Yeah, I do, weakling. You're not that strong, Memma said. Say that when your name's actually in a bingo book and fared throughout the nations, little bitch, Naruto said, shutting up the leaf shinobi as he unleashed his killing intent. So guys, there we have it. Part 3 is over. And if you want part 4, don't forget to like, subscribe, and comment down below. Bye.